Monster fans, and welcome to the third edition of Monster City. I'm your host, Scott Michael. In this edition, you'll follow myself, as well as my minions of Morbid Madness Makers, as we set up Las Vegas' biggest Halloween event for 2005. Now, sit back and relax as we prepare to rip, grind, and burn your nightmares into vivid reality. Here on Monster City. Our story starts here on the streets of Las Vegas as we take a ride with John in his hearse.
Light's still coming off, man.
Yeah.
Are you thinking something serious?
I hope so.
It's July in Las Vegas, and this 1972 hearse just doesn't want to put up with the 110-degree weather. These tourists don't seem to mind the heat as they walk through these oven-baked temperatures. The desert sun's okay with John and I because we've got some big Hollywood fish to fry. We're on our way to the Silverton Casino, where we're going to meet up with the boys from Orange County Choppers. It seems as if we're not the only fans of Orange County Choppers. Bikers and fans have descended on the Silverton Casino from all over the country. Some of these bikes are extremely cool. However, we're here for one reason, and that's to see the unveiling of the new Orange County Choppers motorcycles here at the Silverton Casino. I'll be going inside with the press while John promotes Hysteria City outside.
So, John, have we had fun yet?
Oh, yeah.
A few words to the crowd out there.
Talking to people about the hearse, tell them about Mysterious City.
They love it.
Yeah. Does anybody mention anything about your paint job?
Everybody loves it.
They love it.
Cool.
As John shows off his fresh new paint job to the masses outside, I'll be cruising inside to meet up with the press and the members of Orange County Choppers.
I want to welcome everybody to Silverton Casino Lodge and Bass Pro Shops for our first ever exclusive of the Orange County Choppers from Orange County, New Jersey. Thank you for coming.
Well, look who showed up to the party. It's the crew from West Coast Customs. These guys are most popular from their show, Pimp My Ride. This edition of Monster City is beginning to have an all-star cast.
All right, I'm Q, the manager from West Coast Customs. On my right, we have the owner, Ryan. We have the lovely Mrs. West Coast Customs, his wife. Then we got Alex, you know on the show, does the wheels and tires, but he does a hell of a lot more at the shop. And then his lovely Mrs. Angela, thank you very much, Ryan. The lovely Mrs. Angela. And then you got Danny, who's also on the show, another fabricator. Then we got Tito on the end, who's our PR. If it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be here. He'd make it all happen for us. I just want to say thanks to everybody for coming out. Much love on all the support. Keep watching our show. And definitely keep gambling at the Silverton Hotel and Casino. Come and get it. It's right here.
All right, without any further ado, has anybody ever seen this TV show called Orange County Chopper? Does anyone know who Paul Sr. is? Well, he's here tonight. Does anybody know Paul Jr.? Well, we're lucky to have Paul Jr. here tonight. Well, how about Mikey? Who knows Mikey? Without any further ado, here are the boys, Orange County Choppers. Welcome to Silverton Casino.
Monster fans, bow before the greatness that is the Tuttles. These are some of the world's most excellent and extreme monster fabricators. Paul Tuttle Sr. seemed extremely excited to make his debut performance on Monster City. Paul Jr. seemed to be in good form as well and seemed to enjoy meeting his monster fans. And of course, Mikey was a definite crowd pleaser. But the biggest star of all was his brand new custom-built Orange County Chopper. The boys at OCC made this bike for the Bass Pro Outlet Store. This bike totally represents fishing and the outdoor life. Very cool. I think the boys could step it up and make it cooler. Make a haunt bike for Hysteria City. I think that would be really cool. right here on Monster City. After our exciting meeting with the Tuttles, our inspiration level was peaking through the roof. Speaking of roofs, it looks like Abner's up on the roof of the hotel, raising the skull and crossbone flag. Today we'll be completing the exterior of the hotel for promotional viewing later on this evening. We're trying to gain interest of financial backers so we can make Hysteria City bigger. We'll be adding some new bling bling to the hotel by setting up its exterior facade. We've designed a whole new look for the hotel, and we began to build it. Now it's time to unveil it. And what does Abner think about the look of this newly converted hotel trailer?
It's much work, but I like it. It's beautiful work and something I like it. That one maybe is something crazy, but I'm crazy too. I like it so much. This work is perfect.
Well, I hope so. The people like it, this work. Because I have so much in this, so much time, so much everything.
We've added a 4-foot riser that features a lighted hotel sign and skeleton code. We've also repainted and detailed the entire exterior hotel facade. We've added a lot of subtle ornamentation to the hotel this year, such as raised crown molding, a lighted hotel sign, and dimensional window panels and trim. Not only have we remodeled the exterior of this hotel trailer, we've also completely remodeled the interior. Right on time, John shows up with his hearse to check out the new hotel exterior modifications as well as the interior modifications.
Hey, John is here!
John's hearse will provide an excellent themed backdrop as well as a sitting area for tonight's meeting. We've also managed to complete the hearse paint job featuring some haunted highlights just in time for tonight's meeting. With these extreme makeovers on both the hotel and hearse, Hysteria City is starting to look extremely high-end.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Scott Michael Mann on the scene here with the Hysteria City hearse. We just got some paint on it. And ladies and gentlemen, we spared no expense, I'll tell you. That's right, we only used the finest cheap paint we can get. 99 cents a can. We used about 22 cans to paint this hearse.
Yeah, this paint job cost $20 total in paint.
Well, I guess that proves the old saying true. Looks can definitely be deceiving. I just hope our investors like the new look of the hotel as much as we do.
Yeah, the people that didn't like the haunt. Hang them in the yard arms, idiots.
I suppose John is right. If they don't like it, we'll just hang them up here with the other dummies.
So if you come here, you will like the haunt.
And if John's confident, I'm confident.
You can bet your bones on it. Yeah, no, that's too cool.
Now the only thing left to do is check out the interior of the old Hotel Hysteria. We've remodeled the hotel's interior to resemble that of an old Western movie set. We've also taken the hotel out of the Dark Ages by adding a brand new audio-video system. Now the Hotel Hysteria rocks! This haunt has even been endorsed by Leonard Leatherface Bernarski and Bobby Boris Pickett. We've added many new details, props, and illusions to create extreme eye candy for our 2005 customers. Over the last several weeks, we've made a lot of efforts and progress in getting this trailer ready for our investors' eyes to see. As darkness settles in over the Hysteria City lot, we can only hope that we are able to obtain the funding necessary to create Las Vegas' biggest Halloween adventure. With every tick of the clock, our show gets closer to the point of make or break. Now only time and the opinion of two investors shall determine the fate of this 2005 Halloween adventure we call Hysteria City.